you know, I might as well turn the whole channel into a Queen channel. What's going on, Fort Worth fam? It's the Kid Big Boss Fabo here, and I'm back again with a reaction video. Today, we're doing a Queen reaction, right? To These Are the Days of Our Lives, and it's the official video dropped on the Queen official channel in 2013. Obviously, it was taken from Innuendo 1991. So, obviously, seeing the date, it makes me... I haven't seen this video. I haven't heard the song. But seeing the date makes me obviously wonder if Freddie was actually on the song. Because I know he passed in 91. I don't know. Don't ruin the surprise for me. And I'm not looking in the comments. But I guess we'll find out, you know. But to hear the perspective, I know that Adam Lambert tours with Queen now. You know, and it's like, in the sense, you know, Freddie can't be replaced, and we're not saying anybody can replace him, but to hear the perspective of the music that was coming out right after his passing, if they were even releasing music, I don't know, it's a different perspective. And obviously they were all talented in their own as songwriters, so they could create music. It's not like they relied on Freddie to write the songs, but just the dynamic of the creative process, what the music sounded like, you know, post or after Freddie had you know, passed away. So with that being said, it definitely creates conversation. You guys let me know in the comment section below what y'all think of Adam Lambert, what y'all think about the whole time between after his passing and, you know, what the band was doing. Were they trying to regroup, things of that nature? Because I know one of the band members had retired early, and I think that was right after, not too long after Freddie passed, and I can't think of the exact member who had retired. And I don't want to sound stupid, so I'm not going to say anything. Just comment section below. But you know what I'm referring to if you're obviously Queen stan. But yeah, These Are the Days of Our Lives. This is the official video, like I mentioned. Let's see what we have in store. Like, comment, subscribe.
Sometimes I get to feel it. I was
answering my question
days, long ago, when we were kids, when we were young, things seemed so perfect, you know. The days were endless, we were crazy, we were young. The sun was always shining, we just lived for fun. Sometimes it seems like lately, I just don't know. Rest of my life's been just a show. Those were the days of our lives. The bad things in life were so few. Change.
These Are the Days of Our Lives. That was the official video for from Queen, and obviously Freddie was in the visual, so I answered my own question. But man, just looking at Freddie at this point of his life, I think that I don't know if it was the disease or the sickness, HIV, but just looks real sickly, real skinny. I don't know if he just lost weight or what it was, man. But it definitely hurts to see him like that, especially, you know, as I saw some of the earlier performances and seeing him in his youthful days and so lively. But, you know, with that being said, that's a first. I've never heard the song, but then you always hear the essence of the days of our lives. I wonder if that is always drawn from this moment here, you know, because, I think there is another song called These Are the Days of Our Lives by somebody. But anyways, with all that being said, man, let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. I had kind of covered a couple things just in terms of like their whole, the regrouping of, you know, after he had passed and stuff like that, which I don't really know much detail about. But I know I have a lot of subscribers that lived through that time and, you know, saw it firsthand, experienced it firsthand. And shout out to all my subscribers who's, you know, definitely showing love and support, you know, recanting their stories and their early Queen memories. You know, kind of like painting those pictures and letting us get on, you know, enjoy those rides and those, I guess, those pastimes with them. You know, it's cool always, you know, hearing experiences from other people and them telling about their shows or live performances that they saw or meet and greets. Maybe they even got to meet members of the band. Who knows, man? But I know that I have a lot of heavy Queen fans in my subscriber base in my comment section. That we definitely interact a lot, and I definitely see some cool stories and hear some cool stories from them. So, you know, bless you all, and I definitely appreciate all the love and support. You know, go Queen, man. I'm obviously a new fan, and it's cool to be introduced to new music in the sense of, you know, always having something to draw towards or have something that turns you into a fan, turns you into a supporter, because there's endless amounts of creativity out there that it's able to do that. And, you know, why should I put it past Queen? So yeah, you'll definitely see more Queen reactions coming from me. I don't plan on stopping anytime soon. There's so much content, interviews, you know, perspectives, reactions, things that can be covered in terms of you know, Queen and their legacy, their journey. You know, I might as well turn the whole channel into a Queen channel, if with that being said. But, you know, I definitely wouldn't mind doing that. But, you know, you don't need to worry, or to my subscriber base, you guys don't need to be worried about whether or not these videos will go anywhere, because they won't. You know, I'll still be posting them and definitely just looking for new things. Like, I just posted a musical prostitute interview with Freddie Mercury, and those are the things I like, you know, just seeing the different side, more depth to the artist outside of just the music. So that's what I mean by we can get real three-dimensional with the how I can angle Queen content. You know, don't think that, you know, that they got to run out of songs and content or videos eventually, so what's he gonna react to then? Man, there's always stuff, you know. So with that being said, like, comment, subscribe, you know, engage with my content, keep commenting. I comment back, doing my best to keep up with the comments, because as you guys can see, we're about to hit 2K, man. I'm proud. I'm proud for that, for when that day will arrive. But I'm doing my best to keep up with all the interactions, so forgive me if you see me post 2 days late or something like that. It's all because I'm getting through comments and staying busy, man. So like, comment, subscribe, let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Hit the notification bell, follow me on Instagram at Fort Worth Fabian, and we'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace.